Hey guys, I'm hacking into my brother's computer, so I decided I'm gonna just show you. I do have the hiccups, but this is hacking, so let's record. We're gonna try and connect. This is his computer right here. We're using it remotely. We have my beef here trying to hook into the computers. We're looking for a computer called HackStation. Maybe .11 will work.
At Pacific Office Automation, we are passionate about problem solving. Whatever the size of your business, we'll bring your copiers, printers, scanning, managed IT, and print services together so that your office runs.
I'm gonna have to rerun ifconfig because I just changed my adapter settings. So ifconfig 0.31. We should get a dramatic screen here. Yes. Okay, we did that now. I want to go over to HackStation. What?
Nothing.
He doesn't know what's happening. Framework is down. Wait, okay. We're gonna have to restart beef up again. We're gonna reload our pages too. Okay, so we have to open our virtual machine, root, and beef. Maybe it's backwards. Beef. Really? Okay. I'm gonna look at this video that I just found. There we go, we're in.
At
At Pacific Office Automation, we are passionate about problem solving. Whatever the size of your business, we'll be.
Okay. So now we have no online browser, so let's get hooked. Yeah. Install. Okay. That's all we need. We're going to hook into my brother's computer now. Oh, again, wrong one. Okay, I'm gonna have to go in and try to find the password from this video. I think you put a whole bunch of stuff in the comments.
Patient testing.
So if I go in here, I'm gonna open this with the text editor. Should be here, root beef, okay. Oh, it's B-E-E-F. That was my stupid. But it's not. R-O-O-T. B-E-E-F. Okay, I might have to change my password again. I'll try Tor, which is root backwards. Let's open up my terminal again. What? Store beef. Wait, with what? No clue what's happening. Oh, do I have to use? I may have to use. What? Okay, that was my bad. Let's try again with same login username password root beef. Okay, now let's try to connect. Root B E E S. Okay. Now if I go to QR, / panel, it's not working. Actually, you know, if beef isn't gonna work, then no, I already have Armitage open. Hopefully it has a screen off. Wait. If I could exit a job. Okay, wait. And check his antivirus stats. 1 hour. And now this video will be released days after it's been recorded. This computer don't need any more delete. Maybe I can get into a whole bunch of devices in the network. Hacking is fun. But for now, hopefully one got in. We have to do stuff on console. There we go. Here we go. Please work. One active session. That's all we need. Please work. Please work. Please work. If this works, good things happen. So it's launching now. Oh, my scene just changed. I don't care. Let's go. We have two Nortons disabled. Oh, no, we don't. Freak. Yeah. Okay. That's good. That's really good. Yeah, I am. But you could come and watch. You can get sneak peek. No, please don't go. Please don't go. Please don't go. I'm not smoking it yet. Don't get it. Nope. Let's go. Let's go. More. There we go. His Norton is disabled. Let's go. Let's go. Get in. One time. Just one exploit. That gets in. I have access to the network. Let's go. One down. One down. One down. That's a router. Yes. This is good. This is good. I have to tell you that this is good. Here we go. Okay, we have one down. You can see that right there. I'm gonna look at the router now. The lights are flickering red and green. I don't think he has any clue what happened. This is good. One device down. What device is that? What is this, free BSD? Okay, well. Keep on, let's see, can I get in one more? One more device. Testing a lot of hacks. My Norton is disabled, close. His is too. So we have two disabled Nortons. Let's check other devices. We have my computer, Lenovo PC. That's all okay. Let's see. One device down. Oh, we got shell access. Are you kidding me? Interact. Password is T E no. Happen. Well, we're still in. Let's go. Please save one session. Well, we might have one here. Maps can go. Yep, we want good. One, show me next, yeah. WNR, I know what this is. Password long. That worked. Well, we're into one device. Here we go. Is it adding? No. Oh. We found some new devices, I believe. Nope, same devices. I still have to do trials for all of these. See if they work with my Metasploit. Okay, let's check with Armitage. We're gonna do another Hail Mary. Yes. Where's my Hail Mary script? Here we go. Just trying to see if any of them have websites. Ooh, IIS. I have IIS web server. This is really intense for some reason. Like, Hail Mary! This is baseball. No, I don't know what it is. I keep on forgetting. I don't know what sport. Okay. Does it actually say, you know? Okay, let's go. Where's my FTP server? Yep. Huh, it tried to get into my FTP server. These are actually accounts. Let me see if I can get into my FTP server. They're not gonna work. Oh, it's a status. Okay, same results as last time, so cancel. Okay, we're gonna have to X out. There. And then we're going to have to do. MSO4 modules exploits. So now we have to control C. We're gonna put these under our working folder. So we're pretty certain these are working. Just to make sure, we're gonna delete. And we're gonna paste these ones in. Because we know that those are working. So now we're gonna go to modules, exploits. We're gonna remove these. And then we're gonna open working trials. So trials, and then on this, we're going to go to here, modules, exploits, and you can see there is none. So we're gonna try, these are our trials. So we're gonna test with these ones first. In order to make sure that they're working, we have to open Metasploit. If it starts up successfully, we know it's working. If it doesn't, I'll say it isn't. Okay. This is how you break the console. Ha! I'm starting Metasploit framework console, you see that? It copied it, work console slash console dot dot dot. It's like it's dying. Okay, anyways. It's gonna take while longer because it's loading in more plugins and stuff. Okay, here we're going to go back to this logs. I think we're gonna go to framework log. Oh, it's lagging. It's running really slow. You could really see how quick it is updating. But I'm gonna remove all .txt files if possible. So in order to do that, we're actually, if that's the case, cancel. I don't need this anymore. I'm going to take the exploits that we have here, copy, we're gonna minimize, we're actually gonna take Linux files and we're gonna put them in a temp folder. Okay, so you can see it's copying files now. Should be quicker. It's going through all these useless .txt files. And I'm assuming that that's slowing me down. In the meantime, I'm going to get one of my scripts ready. Prompt. Temp. Where did the folder go? Are you sure about that? My mom said he's big and beautiful. I'm like, are you sure about that? That's the sound of Jonathan. That's annoying. So we're gonna... getting ready to delete all the text files. How come it keeps on closing out? There we go. It's running slow. My computer's running slow. Probably because I have all this stuff open. But you can start to see TMP is filling with files from my Linux machine. Another VMware trick, which is pretty cool. That's not that quick, megabytes per second. Let's go. Go quicker. I said go quicker. That's what I said. Why is it going so slow? It's like we're gonna take forever just to make Joseph mad. No! I disagree with that. Okay, 8,000 files. When it gets to bigger files, this number is going to go down quicker because my computer is really quick. Like copying bigger files. Smaller files? I don't know what's wrong with that. Takes longer. But you can see we're copying a lot of files. Every single time the number changes, that's another thing copied. That's how many files are being copied per sec. How many files left. Go quicker. Sorry about this wait, guys. This is what happens when you have a slow $1,000 computer. I need another one. Okay, Kali Linux is powering off. Okay. Wake up.
We still have to play with you.
That sounded creepy. Okay, we're almost done. One script lost. Pretty good. So now what we're going to do is, there we go. Now it's going to delete all the text files. Let's scroll up. Look at all those files. Actually, how many lines is this? Wait, control A. Entitled, let's see. Deleted 8,999 files. So now we're gonna X out. Don't save. X out. There we go. Now, with that done, how many files are these? 2,000 files. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to our terminal. We're gonna remove these exploits. Oh, just worked. That's funny. Okay, so we're gonna delete these exploits. We're gonna go in temp, copy, paste. Are you gonna load? Copy. Paste. It's taking a long time. I can X out of some stuff, probably. I can. I'm not sure, but I believe the text files. Yeah, I think they're useless. Wish I did control V. Shouldn't take that long, computer. There we go. Sorry. So you apparently have to drag and drop. Now see how quicker it is? Wrong directory. Okay. Jumping on into your computer. Is it not gonna load? No, it's loading. It's just slowly. I don't like slow loading. Where's a desktop? Okay, so we just have to move these to exploits. Mark two, we're gonna just have to move these to exploits. You could see they left our desktop. Now we're going to start a Metasploit, and hopefully this works. And quicker. In order to check, we will go to our home. And we could take a little sneak peek at what's going on. Okay, you can see now how much lines of code are being generated. Oh no, are there? What? Okay, I'm recording still. And what? And we're coming in 15 minutes. Okay, I have to end this in 15 minutes. I don't care. So maybe, hopefully, this works. Okay. Let's see if there's any text files. It should have removed them. If I looked correctly, it should have removed all the text files. Yeah, look, there's barely any files now. no more Pearl. Okay, there's still PHP stuff. So I can see no text files in this, which is good. A lot of PHP exploits. It worked. There we go. So now we can mark this as success. And what we're going to do now is modules, exploits. We're going to copy these into trials, working. Wait, if I go in here, random file. Is there text files? There are. I have an idea. The idea will come soon. Okay, so we know these are working. So we could remove trials. We have less. We're gonna take these ones, and we learned that if we bring them to, well, wait, copy, temp, we know these work, so we don't need them on our drive. See, look how quick they deleted. Now, it should theoretically be putting the files into this temporary folder. And this is how I'm going to join the HSS. Cough Mason. See, look how quick it's working now. So why was it working slow before? Probably because Metasploit was open. So, okay. Hopefully I could just go up. Nope. It's okay. We're going to delete all text files in this directory. txt. Look at that work. Ta-da! See? So now we got 36 files last time I looked. Now, how many files do we have? 6,000. We just saved disk space. Okay. Disk space, nah. Okay, anyways. Wait. Let's just put them back in temp. Okay, where are we gonna put them? Oh. Where do we drag it? So now we're going to remove these. Control C, Control V, paste. No, we tried that, drag and drop. I know what it's gonna do. Something that I wouldn't like, but skip, whatever. Same thing. Okay, you're not gonna respond now. Watch this number go down. There we go. Since the number is now at 0, merge, skip. Why is this not working? Cancel? I think my desktop broke. Okay. Work. I may have to just power restart this because it's not working. Probably not the best thing I could do to a virtual machine, but this is a YouTube video, I can't waste time. I probably did waste a lot of time though. Here we are. Security activity has occurred. I don't disagree with that. Shouldn't bother us with anything this time. Is that all? Yep. So now we just have to copy. We just have to open files. We have to open files is. MSF4, exploit database, working trials. Cause see, these are working trials. Makes sense? Okay, it froze up again. Okay, this is crazy. Well, do I end the video or not? question of the day. Probably should end it. Wait. So that's all for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, hit that like button down below and subscribe. This didn't work exactly as planned. I only got one exploit to work against my system. So one exploit, pretty good, because recently I've got zero exploits due to the recent security patches with Metasploit and these errors. So you can see all of these things got in. So technically, if I didn't have that many antiviruses on the network, I would have hacked in. But I did disable two of them. So, well, the summary of the video is hacking is hard. Bye, guys. And I also just realized my desktop resolution was off. Bye, guys.